Balon. That is the Maya word for the number 9. Hun, ka, osh, kan, ho, wak, wuk, washak, bolon, and lahun. That is how you say the numbers from 1 to 10 in the language of the Maya. Tun, his wife Chenille, his brother Zuk, and the 3 children, Kanal, his sister Ikal, and his cousin Pik, stood looking up at the most amazing building any of them had ever seen. It was 9 stories high, each story smaller than the one below it. Wide stones ran up 2 of the 4 sides, reaching to the top level on which there stood a small building. It was made of stone like the 9-stepped pyramid on which it stood. 9 stories high plus the temple on the top, Tun said. This is the tomb of the great King Pakal. A tomb is a place where someone, usually someone important, is buried. King Pakal lies buried in a great stone case at the very bottom of a hole that runs straight down the center of the temple. There is a staircase in the temple at the top of the pyramid that leads down into the tomb. Can we see it ourselves, Father? Ikal asked. No, it is a special place. Only King Pakal's son, our great king Chan Balom, is allowed inside that temple. The children looked up with even greater interest, knowing that this was a place so special that only a king might enter it. Tun glanced around to see that no one else was listening, then added in a mysterious tone, "They say there is treasure buried with King Pakal." The 3 children turned to look at him with wide eyes, unsure if he was teasing or serious. He went on, "Some say there is green jade carved to make all sorts of fabulous jewelry, bowls, tools, perhaps even furniture. No one knows exactly." Chenille added, "Except for our king, Chan Balom. It was he who put it there, that is, if the tale is true." Pik looked at his father, Zuk. "Do you think it is true, father? Is there really treasure?" Zuk was still staring up at the temple. He answered thoughtfully, "I saw King Pakal once, long ago. He was dressed in robes woven of the finest cotton in many colors, and he wore a headdress of magnificent feathers from the rarest birds. He wore magnificent jade necklaces and carried a scepter carved into wonderful shapes. A scepter is a wand or rod that can symbolize royal power. He did not walk on the earth as we do, but was carried through the streets on a great chair that sat atop 2 long poles laid flat. Important noblemen, for whom carrying the king through the streets was a great honor, carried the king wherever he wanted to go." He turned to look at his son. "I think that if King Pakal wanted to be buried with a treasure of jade, then yes, there must be jade." The children looked at one another in wonder, then back at the pyramid. But Tun and Chenille looked at one another, silently sharing a different thought. They were both thinking, "I've not heard Zuk speak so many words at once in many years." Finally, Tun said to the others, "Let us go see what is on the other side of King Pakal's pyramid. I heard from a man in the market this morning that King Chan Balom is constructing more great buildings over there." To construct means to build something. So they hurried off to see what other sites there might be. Sure enough, Pakal's son, King Chan Balom, had ordered a whole series of buildings to be built. These new buildings were wonderful in their own way, for the roof lines of the temples on top were carved in wonderful designs. When they tired from walking around, they all went to sit in the shade of some wide-spreading trees. After a while, Kanal asked, "Father, why did King Pakal make such a wonderful place to be buried in? It is much greater than the places you showed us this morning where the other kings and queens are buried." Tun answered quietly, "I will tell you, but you must not repeat it." The 3 children grew quiet, sensing that he was about to trust them with some special grown-up sort of secret, then Toon began to tell them about King Pakal.